Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and today we're gonna be taking a look at Premiere Pro's color matching tool. This basically gives you a one-click solution to try and match up the color between two pieces of footage. So let's jump right into it. So here we are inside of Premiere Pro, and we've got two pieces of footage on our timeline that we wanna match the color between. And right off the bat, you can tell that the color is different between them. This can be a big problem in your videos because when you cut from one clip to another and the colors are really different, it can feel very much like a mistake, and it can be distracting for your audience to watch. So how do we match them up so that they feel like one cohesive project? Well, Premiere has this one-click matching feature that can do almost all of the work for you. Start by finding the color match feature by going to your Lumetri color section, and then go down to color wheels and match. Once you drop it down, you can see the color matching section here. And if you click comparison view, you can start working with this feature. Here you can see now that we have a layout that gives us a reference clip and a current clip. You're gonna wanna find a clip whose color you're actually happy with, and this is gonna be known as your reference clip. And it's gonna be located in this window here. This will be the clip that stays the same, and you'll use it as a template to change the color of the other clip with. There's a couple different ways that you can go about choosing this clip. You have a slider down here at the bottom of the frame that you can scrub through, and it'll go through your current timeline so that you can stop on any reference frame of your choice. But what I like to do is have a little bit more control and find the particular frame that I want on my real timeline down here. Then once I've found it, copy the timecode from here, and then paste it into the timecode up here for the reference clip. Now we have exactly the right frame that we want as our starting reference. Next, we're gonna find the clip that we wanna change the color to match the one on the left. This is easy, because it works just by taking the current frame that you're over with your playhead. So once you find the right clip with your playhead, you're ready for the next step. If you wanted to play around with particular ways of viewing your clips, down here you have three particular ways that you can view your reference clip and current clip side by side. You have the first view called side by side, and it's this one that we're currently set up with. But you can also view them as one clip with a linear divide in either a horizontal or vertical divide. And if you select either of these, you can move that divide around to see more or less of a certain clip. Cool, right? Okay, so now that we have our reference and current clip set up to go, what do we do next? Well, truthfully, all of the hard work is already done. There's just two more things to double check. Go over to the color match section and look for face detection. If there's a face prominently displayed in your footage, for example, in a clip like this, then leave this box checked. What this does is ensure that a special degree of care is given to skin tones when matching these two pieces of footage. Because, fun fact, no matter who you are or what color your skin is, all skin tones will appear somewhere in this small region of the color wheel. But if there's no face prominently displayed in your shot, like in this landscape example for instance, then you should uncheck this so that it's not searching for something that's not there. And with that, you're ready to go ahead and hit Apply Match. And you can see that right away, this does a great job of matching the color between our two clips. And if we just do a quick before and after, we can see that the final result is way better than what we started with. And here's the best part. If it does a good job at first, but doesn't get it quite perfect, you can still go ahead and make changes yourself. And you can use what the color match did to give you a much easier starting place. You can use the color wheels down here, like what the color match tool used, or you can go to any other portion of the Lumetri color section and continue to make changes. Now, you can go ahead and make your images look absolutely stunning. And guys, that's just been an overview of the color match tool for Premiere Pro. I hope that you guys found this video helpful. If you did, as always, we've got lots of other tutorials ready for you to view for free here at motionarray.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.